Hello everyone and welcome again to our YouTube channel Engineers World. So today this is a short video regarding the subject of RCC, and it is basically the difference between balanced section, under reinforced section and over reinforced section. This video is made exclusively for interviews because these questions are usually asked in interviews of various competitive examinations. So to understand all these sections, we will discuss each by taking the cross section of a rectangular RCC beam along with its strain diagram. So first of all, we will be starting with our balanced section. So what is a balanced section? So when the ratio of steel to concrete in a section is such that the strain in steel and strain in concrete reach their maximum values simultaneously, or in other words, if this is a cross section of a beam, RCC beam, rectangular RCC beam, in which this is our tension steel, EST, and this is our neutral axis. If I make the strain diagram, we know that the strain diagram is linear, so it will be like this. So as per the definition which I already told you, it says that when the ratio of steel to concrete in a section is such that the strain in steel and strain in concrete reach their maximum values simultaneously. So it is referred to as balanced section. And the percentage of steel in this section will be called as critical steel percentage, or AST max simply. So as per balanced section, our strain in steel, if I represent the strain in steel by epsilon S, it will come out to be epsilon Sy, that is yield value from the diagram. This is our epsilon Sy. And our strain in concrete will be equal to epsilon Cu, which can be shown directly by the strain diagram. This is our epsilon Cu. So the strain in steel and strain in concrete yield simultaneously. So this is all about balanced section. Now in case of balanced section, see, this was our neutral axis. This was our balanced neutral axis. And our actual neutral axis is also overlapped on the balanced neutral axis. So in case of balanced section, our actual neutral axis, if I represent it by XA, depth of actual neutral axis, it will be equal to the depth, critical depth of neutral axis, or balanced depth, that is our XC. So in this case, XC is equal to XA. So this is all about balanced section. Now we will move on to under reinforced section. So our next topic is under reinforced section. So what happens in an under reinforced section? In an under reinforced section, when the percentage of steel in the section is less than the critical percentage, the section is then known as under reinforced section. If this is our neutral axis and this is our cross section of a rectangular beam, if this is our tension steel AST and this is our neutral axis, now in this case what happens? The steel yields before the concrete crushes in compression. Now since the amount of steel is less than that in the balanced condition, so the neutral axis moves above the critical or balanced neutral axis. So our actual neutral axis is like this. So this is our actual neutral axis, which lies above the balanced neutral axis. This one is balanced or critical neutral axis. So if this is our XA, actual depth of neutral axis, and this will be our XC, critical depth of neutral axis. So in this case, XA will be less than XC. Moreover, coming to the strain diagram, here what happens, the steel yields before the concrete crushes in compression. Now, to satisfy the equilibrium condition, that total compression is equal to total tension. So this upward movement of neutral axis continues. And the moment resisting capacity till the extreme compression fiber reaches its ultimate strain epsilon Cu. So the strain distribution diagram can be shown as like this. So what happens in a under reinforced section, this will be our strain in steel and this is our yield strain, you can say, and this is our yield, ultimate yield in concrete, and so from this strain diagram it is clear that our strain in steel is greater than its yield value, and our strain in concrete will be, it will be also, it is somewhat greater than strain in concrete is somewhat less than its yield value. This was strain in, and this is our strain in concrete. So, due to this, in case of under reinforced section, the failure is initiated by steel reaching its yield value first, but finally the collapse of beam occurs due to crushing of concrete. So, the failure of an under reinforced beam is characterized by substantial deflection and extensive cracking of the concrete, giving ample warning of impending failure. So for this reason and from economy point of view, we always prefer under reinforced sections because they are always better as far as economy is considered. And at the time of failure, steel fails first in under reinforced section, and this is basically a ductile failure. So in case of under reinforced section, ductile failure takes place. So this was all about under reinforced section. Now moving on to the next, that is our over reinforced section. So as the name suggests, over, it is simply understood that when the percentage of steel is more than the critical percentage, then the section is known as over reinforced section. So if this is our neutral axis and this is our cross section, see, this is our balanced neutral axis in this case, and in case of over reinforced section, as the percentage of steel is more than critical percentage, so the actual neutral axis shifts below the balanced neutral axis. So this is our actual neutral axis. And this is our tension steel, and or this steel is greater than ST max. So since the amount of steel is more than that in the balanced section, so the neutral axis moves below the balanced neutral axis for satisfying equilibrium condition. So which results in concrete reaching its ultimate strain while the strain in steel remains less than its yield value. This can be shown by this strain diagram. So from this strain diagram, you can see clearly. From this strain diagram, it is clearly seen that the concrete reaches its ultimate strain. This is its ultimate strain, epsilon cu. Concrete reaches its ultimate strain while the strain in steel remains less than its yield value. This is the yield value of strain in concrete. And when the concrete, strain in steel, and when the concrete has reached its yield value, or strain in concrete is epsilon s, that is less than its yield value. So what happens with the compressive strain in concrete reaching its ultimate value first? So the sudden failure of beam occurs by crushing of concrete without giving any warning. So in this case, there is brittle failure or sudden failure, and this gives no warning. So design codes therefore restrict the percentage of tension steel in reinforced concrete beam to that of balanced section. So we never design over reinforced section. If we are getting an over reinforced section, then we will design a balanced section. So in this case also, if this is our critical depth of neutral axis or balance, this will be our actual depth of neutral axis. So our actual depth of neutral axis is greater than its critical depth of neutral axis. So in case of over reinforced section, there is a brittle failure. The strain, when the strain in concrete reaches its ultimate value or yield value, the strain in concrete is less than its yield value. So this was its strain diagram. So due to which crushing of concrete occurs, and there is sudden failure. So this was all about an over reinforced section. So we never design an over reinforced section. So this was all about today's topic. Hope you would have liked the